LakesFM 107.
There are easier ways of waking up.
Don't forget to tune in to Lakes FM on 107 FM every Saturday and Sunday from 7 till 9 for a full English breakfast with your hosts, me, Pete Story.
And me, Darren Milby, for a lot of music, a lot of entertainment, and a lot of shouting. And guess what, girls? We're also available.
Another button pressing operation successfully completed. The sport. Is this today's? Or is it like sport from in history?
No point. This time last week.
I know, but if you look.
Yeah, no, it's today's sport.
Right, I stand corrected, Martin.
Which I've got to Carl's weather as well. Give and read.
I'll do that after.
Yeah,
but do this one. I'm going to play Boyzone and then I'll do the weather.
Okay.
You can always dream. We can. I mean, don't dream, it's over, you know. hey, sport. What's the sport looking like for today?
Okay, well, in the football, England are versus Sweden today, of course, the Euro 2000 qualifying match, and it's at Wembley Stadium. Sweden beat England 2-1 when the two sides last met in September 98. So, fingers crossed there, we can turn that around this time. And in horse racing, it's the Vodafone Derby meeting at Epsom in Surrey, and also the Belmont Stakes at Belmont Park in New York. And to start with the TT races today, motorcycling course in the Isle of Man. Exciting day for sports.
Very exciting day for sports. And stay tuned, because coming up very shortly, we're going to give you a weather report on the weather in the Fells, just in case you fancy a walk out there today. And stand by also, because we'll give you a recap on the competition in around about 10 minutes' time. But right now, for me, it's a boy's own moment.
Hey, all right.
How are you doing?
I've seen you on the internet this week.
You've seen me on the internet?
Your name on the snooker pages.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. You see, the World Championship, all the way back to the early rounds.
All right. And how bad I did.
And, yeah, Lynn told me you're professional. So
yeah, I had a bit of a nightmare session there, actually.
Is it?
Yeah, how bad?
We do love our boys' own moments, don't we, on the programme? That's a great old picture of you from the film Bean, of course. It's 29 minutes tonight. Good morning, Lakes FM 107. And it's Darren and Pete for the next half hour, until 9 o'clock this morning. And then it's Millie, who's on at 9. And a guest on his show, he has Ian Carnaby, media personality. He'll give you more details about that later on, but an exclusive interview here on Lakes FM. Right, it's time to have a look at the weather on the Fells. We're going to do that in just a tick. And following that, we have the lovely Britney Spears.
Good morning, Kendall. It's 8:30, and here's your weather. Today, there'll be 50% chance of showers, and it'll be cloudy as well. Winds are light and westerly, and today's high in Kendall is 16 degrees Celsius. If you fancy a walk in the Fells today, winds are light and south to southwesterly at all levels. It's going to be 6 degrees Celsius at 3,000 feet. There'll be scattered broken cloud between 2,500 feet and 3,000 feet, and the visibility is good, but poor with the showers at 100 metres or less. And at 1,200 feet, there will be quite a few showers there as well.
The competition this morning, loads of correct callers so far. If you'd like to add your name to the list, then give us a call. We're looking for the band which sang songs such as The Air That I Breathe, Bus Stop, Carry On, songs like that. You know the kind of band, I mean. The options are the Ebonys, was it them? Was it the Ivories? Was it the Hollies? Or was it the Berries? Okay, you sang The Air That I Breathe. I have to win yourself a McDonald's meal this morning.
Right, good morning, it's The Breakfast Show on Lakes FM 107 with myself, Peter Story, and Darren Milby, the King of the Night.
Hello.
Like I said, we're not going to go into his nickname. Hey, that's pretty much the end of The Breakfast Show for this quite dull and miserable Saturday morning. Oh, we hope we've brightened it up for you, and hey, it's going to get a whole lot brighter because DJ Millie's on. And he's looking very nice today in his blue shirt, so he'll be keeping you happy with his mystery guest as well today at 9 o'clock, so stay tuned for that. But that's it from me.
and myself. We're back tomorrow morning at 7 for the final breakfast show. It's all very tinged with sadness, I'm afraid. But yes, we're here for the last time tomorrow between 7 and 9. And joining us on the programme, we have Thea Gilmore. She's a young singer-songwriter, and she's going to be chatting to us tomorrow morning and performing a few songs live for us, including this one, which we're going to play out to the news with.
Yeah, it's just a sample, taking us up to the news. So we'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
7. See you then.
Bye-bye.
Hi, this is Andy Milliard, alias DJ Millie. Why not join me Saturday mornings between 9 and 11, where I'll have for you the best in music from the 60s through to the 90s and some mysterious guests and prizes. So leave the shopping until later and tune in to 107 Lakes FM. It's music to your ears.
Andy Milliard here, taking you through till 11 o'clock. And sadly this morning, it's my last programme. I'll be back next time, will I? That one comes out, that record there, that comes out, original by Madonna, that comes out next month. It's by Girls and it's called Holiday. On my last two programmes I've had some mystery guests. I've got another one this morning. And I'm going to be giving you a clue in just a short while. Now then, after the last two shows, we had George and Zippy in on the first programme from Rainbow. We had Frank Spencer in last week. Who's it going to be this week? This week's mystery guest.
I'm going to give you a t-shirt this morning. I'm going to give you a Lakes 107 FM t-shirt. Hey, they're pretty cool and trendy. You know that?
Well, I guess where I was last night. I was out on the road DJing again last night, and I mean, I've done quite a lot of places. I've been DJing quite a lot of years now, and I've done quite a lot of silly sort of places as well. But last night topped it off, I tell you. I was in a barn last night. I was DJing in a barn last night, and it had this wooden floor. And I thought, oh, that's a little bit worrying, because I thought my records would be jumping. But I was actually on CD last night, so it wasn't so bad. So I thought, well, I'll get away with it. And anyway, they all started dancing, and every single record jumped. And so I had to put some tape down, and God, it was a right mess. But it was a good night. We had a really good night. And I'll tell you something, right, we had a barbecue as well. They actually put on a barbecue, and he asked me if I'd like some drinks. So obviously I said yes, because I was absolutely famished. And it was a chicken in wine sauce and creamed mushrooms. I thought I was in a restaurant, and I was in a barn. I couldn't believe it. Anyway, there you go. Yeah, all right, now don't get too carried away. Look, I don't want you getting too carried away with yourself, all right? I mean, you have this anything as it is, and I'm trying to bring that out. Am I bringing that out in you?
Yes.
All right, then. Now, that's good, then. So, coming up just after 10 o'clock, we've got our Ed. Ed's in this morning. He's just going to slip in the hot seat here, and he's going to be interviewing a Radio 5 sports personality. Well, called Ian Carnaby, Radio 5. He's coming up just after 10 o'clock, and our Ed's going to be throwing a few questions to him. If you just tuned in to us at Lakes 107 FM, a very good morning to you. Andy Milliard here with you through to 11 o'clock. Coming up after this, we'll have a little bit of the weather, see how it's getting on. Been playing this over my last couple of shows, thought I'd give it another whirl. It could be getting released soon, this one, I'm sure of it. It's by Fawn Hill, originally done by the Fat Boy Slim, and it's called Praise You. Check this one out.
Already wrong, there's a minute left. Very privileged to have in the studio here at Lakes FM Ian Carnaby, who, as a lot of you will know, used to present Sport on 2 on Radio 2, what was Radio 2 for 5 years, and is now Radio 5, of course. He also presented, he was the sports presenter on HTV West. And he left that to do, when the bookies started showing all the horse racing, Ian presented all those as well. He's now a freelance journalist and does things for Sporting Life and the Irish Field. And how are you going, Ian?
Well, I'm going very well, Ed. Nice of you to invite me along.
It's a pleasure, the derby. It's the big one today, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's got to take its place against a lot of other top sports as well. Personally, I don't think they should have moved the derby from a Wednesday, because then it did have the focus all to itself. I appreciate in marketing terms you've got to go for the bigger crowds, etc. But it will take place today roughly halfway through an England football international, and that can't be a good thing. I much preferred a Wednesday derby, I must be honest.
Well, you've done it in a nutshell there, because I'll be watching the football, and yep. Hopefully Liverpool, England will be 3-0 up by then, so we can switch over and watch the derby. But it's wrong to have the two big events clashing, isn't it?
It is a shame.
On the TV. Anyway, down to the nitty-gritty, what do you reckon's going to win it?
Well, it's a question of what will win it and what's the value. That they do say that Frankie Dettori's horse, Dubai Millennium, has worked very well again this week. He won't be a realistic price. My guess is that he will go off favourite at around 4-1, 7-2 perhaps. He's possibly the one to beat. He's got plenty of class. A horse that I quite liked when I was at York a few weeks ago for the big May meeting there is Zargier, right down at the bottom. It was a good two-year-old, and he won at York despite being in difficulties all the way up the straight. He was badly pocketed, boxed in, and I thought Richard Hills would barge his way out and possibly get disqualified, but he just finessed him out. He won pretty easily in the end, and the form has been franked by the second. It's a terribly difficult derby. He's not absolutely certain to stay a mile and a half, Sergio, but you can get at least 12-1, possibly 14s or 16s, and for me, in a terribly tricky race where I suspect it'll be quite rough as well, because it's a big field and sort of deadish, slippy ground, there could be a couple of barging incidents. He would be okay each way value, but I wouldn't be reaching for the wallet too confidently.
Put in your shirt. Right, we're going to play a quick record, and then now I've been told about spread betting, and you're going to enlighten us all about that one.
I'll try to.
Right, so we'll play a little record, and then we'll come back in a few minutes with that one. Right, thank you very much indeed, and we'll hand you back over to Millie.
What do you want to go and see at the pictures?
I'm really not bothered.
Well, how about Existence?
Maybe.
Well, Rugrats is on.
Possibly.
Or The Thin Red Line.
Well, we could do, but...
Shakespeare in Love?
Oh, I don't know. There's just so much to choose from.
Well, we obviously should have listened to Lisa and Matt's film show on Saturday afternoon from 2 till 3 to find out the best of the new releases at the cinema and on video.
Cracking idea.
I have to get some food before I go watch the football. Sorry.
Yeah, you are starving today. I've had to listen to his stomach rumbling all afternoon.
I'll eat you if you're not careful.
What are you going to tell us about next?
Right, this is brilliant. This is fantastic. This is New Line Cinema's new film.
Right.
Freddy versus Jason.
Oh,
Freddy Krueger.
Yeah.
And Jason.
From Nightmare. No.
From Friday the 13th.
Right, yeah.
And it's... It's just brilliant because there's pictures of them and they're like sparring. Great. they're now 16 and 20 years old, respectively, those two. But it's coming out. It is definitely coming out.
Right.
Jason X shortly afterwards as well, which is the new Jason film, Friday the 13th.
There's another Friday the 13th film?
Yes.
So what's that one?
Jason X.
10.
10. Oh, Roman numerals.
I know my Roman numerals. Did I put the next tune in?
I think you did.
I did.
It's all queued up.
I remember what it is.
Go on.
Beautiful South, Beautiful South. It's Rotterdam. Shall I just tell a little bleep, 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 bleep? I am starting to get a tear in my eye.
Dear, have a flower.
Oh, Matt, thank you. Isn't that nice? It's a carnation. It's almost done.
I just found it. I'm not doing this.
It's been trodden on.
You hush. Should we play another tune?
Yeah, okay.
All right. I chose, didn't I? No, you chose.
And I can't remember what it was.
Oh, Matt can't remember. Matt can't remember. Oh, no, I chose. It was the... It's great.
All right,
music to your ears. It's LakesFM. Music to your ears. On 107. Music to your ears.
Say good afternoon, it's Saturday. It's another Saturday afternoon, we've got the Lakes FM Charity Show between now and 6. Recap on last week's top 5, and at number 5, Shania Twain. Well, it was a non-mover on last week's chart countdown at number 5. Don't impress her much, is that Shania Twain? And at number 4 last week, slipped a place for sixpence, none the richer. This is Kiss Me here on Lakes FM.
Well, even when summer comes, you pray for rain, but always take your coat. And standing there getting wet, you wish you'd listen to the radio. Too late.